टुडे टॉपिक ऑफ लेक्चर कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर रेशियोस। दिस रेशियोस आर डिवाइडेड टू कैटेगरीज, डेबिट इक्विटी रेशियो, इंटरेस्ट कवरेज रेशियो। कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर रेशियो first one is debit equity ratio. This ratio establishes a relationship between long term debits and shareholders funds. This ratio computed by dividing the debit by equity or long term loans by shareholders funds. This formula, debit equity ratio is equal to debit by equity or long term loans by shareholders funds. What is debit or long term loans? These all are debit or long term loans. Debentures, this also one type of loan or give the bonds outsiders to the company, that period also more than 5 years. Loans for specialized finance institutions, this provide the loans companies or businesses, some special institutions, state financial corporation or industrial development corporation or national banks. This long term loans, long term loan means payments of amount more than 2 years, that all are loans are long term loans. Public deposits, you collect the outside deposits. Loan and mortgage, you take the loan in the banks, you or assets mortgage for taking the loans. Term loans, this long term loans. Secured loans, this also long term loan. These all are debits or long term loans. These all are items, you understand. Next, equity or shareholders fund. These all shareholders are investors or business peoples. These all are shareholders fund. Equity share capital, performance share capital. Share capital are divided the two types, equity share capital, performance share capital. Next, reserves, surplus amount, previous profits in the business. General reserve, capital reserve. These all are shareholders funds or equity. It is total less than any preliminary expenses, this less. Any losses previous, these all are less, this total shareholders fund. These all are you identify the, understand the what is shareholders fund. Equity share capital, preference share capital, reserves, surplus, previous profits, general reserves, capital reserves, less preliminary expenses or previous losses. These all are shareholders' funds. If these all are you understand, give the problem. You identify any these items that all are shareholder funds or equity. Next problem. For the following data, collect the debit equity ratio. From the following data, calculate the debit equity ratio. 10,000 equity shares of 10 rupees each, 1 lakh. General reserve, 45,000. Accumulate profit, 30,000. Debentures, 75,000. Sundry trade creditors, 40,000. Outstanding expenses. This is problem. This you identify the this ratio for calculation only long term loans and shareholders fund. Already known the above table. This share capital is the shareholders fund, general reserve also shareholder fund, accumulate profit. Accumulate mean previous profits, previous year's profits. This also shareholder fund or equity. Debentures, it is a long term liability. This is also debentures. Sundry trade creditors, this is not long term liability, this current liability. This is not considered in this formula, in this problem. Next, outstanding expenses, this is also current liability. First, the solution, debit equity ratio is equal to debit by equity or long term loans by shareholders fund. First you calculate the debits or long term loans. Identify the this problem. Debits are long term loans. Share equity shares, this is not debit. General reserve, not debits. Accumulate profit, this is not debits. Loans. Debentures, this is the long term loan. Debentures, 75,000. Next, sundry trade creditors, this is not a long term loan, it is a current liability. This is not considered in this problem. Outstanding expenses, this is also current liability. This is not considered in this problem. All are over. Next one, you calculate the equity or shareholders fund. Equity shares, 1 lakh. 1 lakh. Next, general reserve, 45,000. Next, accumulate profit. This is also previous profit. This is also shareholders fund. This debentures, this already you take the long term loan. Sundry trade creditors, this is also current liability, not considered. Outstanding expenses also current liability. In this only consider the long term loans and shareholders' funds, not consider the current assets and current liabilities in this problem, in these ratios. Next, you total the equity or shareholders fund. This 1,75,000. You calculate the debtors and long term loan or shareholders fund. You apply the formula. Debit equity ratio is equal to long term loans by shareholders fund. Long term loan also debentures 75,000. Equity or shareholders funds. This equity or shareholders fund 1,75,000 is equal to 0.42 times. This problem is over. Next one is interest coverage ratio. This is one of the capital structure ratio. This ratio establishes a relationship between profit before interest, tax and interest. This ratio is calculated as interest coverage ratio is equal to net profit before interest and tax by interest. This formula. First, you calculate the net profit before interest and tax. Next, you calculate the interest. Problem. The operation profit of Raja Limited after charging interest on debentures and tax is sum of rupees 4 lakhs. The amount of interest is 30,000 and the provision for tax has been made of 70,000. Calculate the interest charge coverage ratio. This is problem. In this net profit after pay the tax and interest 4 lakhs, interest also 30,000, tax also 70,000. First, you formula interest coverage ratio is equal to net profit before interest and tax. Net profit before interest and tax by interest. Before interest means not pay the interest, not pay the tax. This profit is the already paid and interest and tax after net profit. You require that this formula apply net profit before interest and tax. Interest also 30,000, this formula. First, you calculate the net profit before interest and tax. Profit after charging interest on debentures and tax. This pay chesin tarvata 4 lakhs after pay debentures interest and tax. Next, interest on debentures 30,000. Provision for tax 7,000. Total 5 lakhs. Net profit before interest and tax, not paid the interest and tax, that time profit is 5,000. Already paid interest and tax, profit is 4 lakhs. Our required or need of the this problem, net profit before interest and tax, this is not, this is the required. So this is net profit after paid interest and tax. So you calculate the before interest and tax. That purpose this add to the tax and interest, the total 5 lakhs. Interest is interest on debentures 30,000 in this. So the problem, this interest, the amount of interest 30,000. This formula apply. So apply interest coverage ratio is equal to 5 lakhs by 30,000 is equal to 16.67 times. This problem is over. Next one is activity or turnover ratios. This ratio is also referred as asset management ratios. The activity ratio measures how effectively an organization manages its asset. Activity ratio is classified as inventory or stock turnover ratio. This ratio establishes a relationship between cost of goods sold and average inventory. This ratio calculated as formula. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold by average inventory. This ratio known the relationship between cost of goods sold and average inventory. This is formula. Inventory or stock turnover ratio. Cost of goods sold is equal to opening stock plus purchases for plus direct expenses minus closing stock. This formula apply for calculation to cost of goods sold. Or cost of goods sold is equal to net sales minus gross profit. This is also used. Net profit minus gross profit. These all are give the problem. You only apply the these formulas. Net sales is equal to sales minus sales returns. Next, average inventory. Average inventory is equal to opening stock plus closing stock by 2. Average inventory is equal to opening stock plus closing stock by 2. Formula, problem. These all are formulas. You calculate the calculate the inventory or stock turnover ratio. Inventory turnover ratio is called cost of goods sold by average inventory. Cost of goods sold is called opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock, or cost of goods sold is called net sales minus gross profit. Net sales is called sales minus sales returns. Average inventory is called opening stock plus closing stock by 2. Next, one problem in this method. Calculate stock turnover ratio in the following cases. First one, A, cost of goods sold 2 lakhs, average stock 40,000. Next two, B, sales 2,20,000, average stock 40,000, sales returns 20,000, gross profit 20% on sales. Next C, opening stock 21,000, closing stock 29,000, purchases 1 lakh, wages 10,000. This is problem. You calculate the stock turnover ratio A, B, C. First A, inventory turnover ratio is called cost of goods sold by average inventory. This is formula. Our need required for this ratio calculation, cost of goods sold and average inventory. In this problem, A, cost of goods sold 2 lakhs, average stock 40,000. This is all available in the problem. You apply formula. Cost of inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold by average inventory. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold, how much? 2 lakhs. Average stock 40,000. You apply the formula. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to 2 lakhs by 40,000 is equal to 5 times. This first bit is over. Next one is B, sales 2,20,000, average stock 40,000, sales returns 20,000, gross profit 20% on sales. B, same apply the formula. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold by average inventory. This formula is not directly give the cost of goods sold, only some information. That based you calculate the cost of goods sold, this information. No, in this cost of goods sold, you calculate the cost of goods sold. Average stock also already give the problem. First you calculate cost of goods sold. That purpose some formulas also available. Cost of goods sold is equal to net sales minus gross profit. Netto sales is equal to sales minus sales returns. Net sales, sales also give problem. Give the problem. Sales or give the problem. 2,20,000 minus sales returns 20,000 minus sales returns 20,000 is equal to net sales 2,00,000. Next, gross profit, that use of the not direct amount in the problem, not give the direct amount in the problem. Gross profit, gross profit 20% on sales. You already you calculate the sales. You gross profit 20% on the sales. Gross profit is equal to sales into 20%. Gross profit net sales 2,00,000 into 20% is equal to 40,000. Cost of goods sold is equal to net sales minus gross profit. This problem, cost of goods sold is equal to net sales minus gross profit is equal to 1,60,000. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold by average inventory. You calculate the cost of goods sold 1,60,000. Inventory, average inventory also give the problem. Give the problem. Average stock or inventory. Average stock give the problem. You apply the formula by 40,000 is equal to 4 times. This is over. Next bit is C. Next C, opening stock 21,000, closing stock 29,000, purchases 1,00,000, wages 10,000. Wages is the direct expenses. This is the information in this problem. That based on the, you calculate the inventory or stock turnover ratio. That is formula is inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold by average inventory. This is two items also need, cost of goods and average inventory. In this problem, no cost of goods sold, no average inventory. You calculate some formulas that purpose. Cost of goods sold is equal to cost of goods sold is equal to opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. Opening stock 21,000, purchases 1,00,000 plus direct expenses 10,000 minus closing stock. Total 1,31,000 minus 29,000 is equal cost of goods sold 1,02,000. Next one is average inventory. Now give the average inventory in the problem. You based the this information, you calculate the average inventory or average stock. That purpose use the formula. Average inventory is equal to opening stock plus closing stock by 2. In this problem is available opening stock. Opening stock is 21,000. Closing stock is 29,000. Opening stock plus closing stock. This opening stock 21,000 plus closing stock 29,000 by 2 is equal 50,000 by 2 is equal 25,000. You apply the formula. You calculate the cost of goods sold and average inventory. To apply formula, you calculate the inventory turnover ratio is equal to 1,02,000 by 25 is equal to 4.08 times. This problem is over. Thank you.